In this video, I'm going to show you how you can connect Dubsado and ClickUp together using Zapier. We're basically going to say when a project starts inside Dubsado, create something inside ClickUp from our template. This will be a pretty simple setup to create. Should take about 15 to 20 minutes if you're doing this for the first time. If you're familiar with these tools, it'll probably take you much less. But before we dive into the weeds of setting up this connection, I just want to make sure we're all clear on what the tools involved are doing. So the very first tool we're going to be using for this automation is, you guessed it, Dubsado. And if you're not aware, Dubsado is a business management platform. It helps you keep track of expenses, sort of, billing, proposals, contracts, appointments, and other automations that are perfect for a one-on-one service provider business. I'll admit it's a very simple tool with a lot of customization, mostly around aesthetics. As you can see in here, Dubsado's actual interface is very clunky and ugly, and it feels very old, but the experience you're able to give clients with Dubsado using custom HTML and different automations, which they call workflows inside Dubsado, can be extremely powerful. Now, Dubsado's actually been a tool that's been in my tech stack for a while, but for various reasons, I'm in the process of moving away from it. If you guys would like to hear more about why I'm moving away from Dubsado, just leave a comment and I'll maybe release a video on that. But needless to say, that is what Dubsado is. That is what Dubsado does. It is really good for managing the client relationship and more of the business side of things. So finances, billing, proposals, that kind of stuff. And on the other side of our connections today, we're gonna be using ClickUp. Now, I hope I don't have to explain what ClickUp is if you're watching this channel, because I've released like over 100 videos about it. But let's leave it to say that ClickUp is a task management tool on steroids. It has a lot of features that make it do a lot more than a simple checklist, including docs, formulas, dashboards, and so on and so forth. If you don't know what ClickUp is, I do have a whole playlist on beginner features here that you might want to check out. Now, those are the two tools on either side of this equation. You're probably already familiar with them, so let's just dive into how we're going to connect the two of them together. And that brings me to our third and final tool involved here, which is Zapier. Now, Zapier is an integration tool. Really, what it does is it connects data from one tool into another tool without you having to retype data manually, which I know we've all been guilty of at times, retyping information from Dubsado into ClickUp or vice versa. With a tool like Zapier, you can have that happen in a zap and not have to do it manually. I'll also say Zapier isn't the only tool that does this. Competitors might include Integromat, Integrately, and so on and so forth. So just like Dubsado and ClickUp, there are alternatives you could look at. The important thing is we need an integration tool to make this connection a possibility. So to actually get started and get building here with all that basic information out of the way, we need to go into Dubsado, log in with your existing account, and create a form. Now you can create a form under Templates, Forms, and then just create any sort of form. Because the automation we're going to build today is about a project starting in Dubsado and an area being created in ClickUp, we are going to make a proposal inside of Dubsado. So I just made a really simple one here. It is just a support ticket proposal. I have a few fields that I dragged in here. Now, your form can be any sort of form that you might build in Dubsado, but the important thing is that it has a first name, a last name, and an email address as required if you're going to have this form available publicly. Now, in this example, I have a support ticket form. So this is a form that I'm going to put on my website. And then when the form is submitted, I'm going to create a support ticket task in my support ticket list inside ClickUp. So because I'm going to have it public, I'm going to make sure that these three fields are required so I can then share the form publicly. If I do not have these fields required, it will not let me share the form publicly, and I will only be able to apply this form directly to a project inside ClickUp, which is a manual process. So that's something to keep in mind. For most applications, you're gonna want all of these to be required, both so you can make sure your data is correct and also so you can share them with people who don't already have projects started in ClickUp. For most applications, you're gonna wanna have these three fields required just so that you have the option to share the form publicly in case you don't wanna apply it directly to an existing client project. Now, on the setting side of this form, we wanna make sure that when this is all submitted, we want to create a new project because that is going to be the trigger for this workflow. We want to have ClickUp stuff created when a project starts, not a lead, not anything else, just a project. So it's very important that we have the create a new project option turned on here. Now, again, if we were using a different trigger, we could do something different, but because we are trying to start based on a project, we need this here. We could also choose to set up a workflow here, which is Dubsado's versions of automations. I'm not going to do that for now. I could also choose a redirect or project status of different types. Maybe I'll choose active, and so on and so forth. And finally, a lead title. Now, I would encourage you to fill out this lead title with something that's gonna make sense. So I'm gonna call this something like support ticket. And that will just give me a label for the project once it's created. There we go, we're good with this. We're gonna click save. Okay, so we have our form created. Now let's go into Zapier and let's connect this to ClickUp. So to go into Zapier, we need to create an account if we don't already have one, and then go into the make a Zap area. So we're gonna choose what app we're gonna connect with the other app. So in this case, we're gonna connect Dubsado, we know this, right? Dubsado to ClickUp. Now, once we say what tools we want, it's gonna ask us what trigger and what action. Just like with ClickUp automations, we need to tell it what we wanna have happen and when. So when, in this case, we wanna say when a new project is a job, because that's when our project is kicking off. Then we wanna have something be created in ClickUp. Now, this is gonna depend on how you organize your projects in ClickUp as to what layer you want. Now, if you're not sure if your project in ClickUp should be a space, a folder, a list, or a task, watch this video up here because it'll probably really help clarify that for you. But for now, we're going to assume when a new project is created in Dubsado, we want to create a task in ClickUp because we, in this imaginary world, have a task per client structure. So I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna choose create a task. So I can scroll down until I see create a task, and there we go. Now to go ahead and start building this, we can click try it and it'll take us to the editor view. And this is where we can really start to customize our automation and map certain fields. Let's just go ahead and do it together. Now the very first thing we need to do is connect our Dubsado account. If you've already used Zapier with Dubsado before, it'll show up here. Otherwise, we need to create a new account. Now, what you'll need here is an API key from Dubsado. When you go into Dubsado and you go under settings and then brand settings and then integrations, you will see the Zapier icon here. You're gonna just need to go into this and click generate token, and that'll give you a unique long string of text, which you can then paste into the pop-up from Zapier. Just paste that exact link in here, the token key, and click continue, and it'll just prompt you to confirm some information and you will have Dubsado connected. Very simple process. Once it's connected, just select from the dropdown and click continue. Before we move on to the ClickUp step, it's just gonna ask you to do a quick test. It always does this when you're setting up something with Zapier. And this is just saying, hey, let's just make sure that the information's pulling in. So here we can see that the information did pull in. We are good to go to the next step of the process. So we're gonna click continue. So in the next step, we need to start specifying what exactly do we wanna have happen in ClickUp when that trigger of a new job as a project occurs. So we're gonna go in here and we're gonna say create task. We've already selected that. I'm not gonna change my mind now. Click continue. Now we only have to do this the first time, so bear with me here. We need to go down here and click connect a new account. If you've already used Zapier before, it's going to prompt you to connect ClickUp with your different workspaces. If you have no accounts connected, you'll probably need to log in with ClickUp. Just follow the prompts. It's pretty straightforward. And just connect the workspaces that you would like to have connected with Zapier. Once you do that, just select your account or whichever accounts you want to use and click continue. Now, the final step of this creation is just choosing where we want to have the task created and what do we want to have in that task. The where should be pretty easy. We probably want to have it in our workspace. We'll put it in the demo workspace I have. What space do we want to have it in? I don't know. We have a bunch of junk in here. Let's just pick a spot. And finally, we get to the details. Now we need to choose the folder, just do no folder, and the list that we want to have it in. What list do we want to have it to be in? And so on. So just choose what folder, list, space, you know, the location that you want to have your tasks in. This should be wherever you normally put your client work. Now we've picked the location. This next one allows us to pick a template. So perhaps you have someone buying service A and you have a template for how you always deliver service A. We want to choose our service A template here. And if you don't know how to use ClickUp templates, watch this video, it'll give you a crash course. But basically, templates are pre-made task list spaces, whatever level you're building at. So in this case, maybe just I'll choose some random template I have here that might, let's just say consultation. This is my consultation template. Let's just imagine this is a consultation being booked. So when this task is created through Zapier, it'll also apply this consultation template to my task. And again, if you use list, it would be a list template, folder would be a folder template, so on. Next up, we have task name. And now this is where we get to start pulling in Dubsado information. Because as of right now, all we've done is create a task. That's not showing me anything from Dubsado quite yet. So when it comes to task name and these extra fields that are available here, we want to start mapping information from Dubsado into ClickUp. And all mapping is if you ever used an email automation tool and it's like, hello, first name, and first name gets replaced with the person's actual first name, that's what we're talking about here with mapped or dynamic fields. We are basically saying, here's the title of the project. See, it says title from Dubsado. It's got the little Dubsado icon. We're gonna make the title of the Dubsado project the title of the task in ClickUp. I could also choose to make a space, type some words, and also put maybe the client first name in there or any of the other fields available in Dubsado. I'm pulling them all into the task name. Now, that's not to say that those are the only places I could put them. I could also choose to maybe remove my template here so that way it's not mapping out stuff. If I remove my template selection from Zapier, and this is just a weird quirk, if I don't add a template, I can also add fields directly into the other elements of ClickUp. So this might be the task description, the assignees, the status, the due date. These other fields can also be mapped with data. So in this case, I probably want to pull as much information as possible from Dubsado into my task description. So I could say client, just typing this so it always shows up that way. And then I'm going to put the first name, space, last name. All right, next one. What other options do we have here? Company name, phone number. And we're going to type the phone number of the client. So each of these fields is going to be replaced with the actual information from Dubsado every time this is triggered. And we got to these settings by removing the template because those two things are in conflict. Quick note about Zapier here, you'll notice my custom fields are not available. They're just not. With Zapier, its connection with ClickUp isn't the strongest, so we're not able to set custom field values here. If we're using some of the Zapier competitors, such as Integromat, we would be able to access that. But Integromat is more complex, Zapier is more simple and easy to use, so for the sake of this tutorial, I figured the trade-off of custom fields or not custom fields, we go with the simple tool, and that's why we have this here. So we pulled in a few fields, we've mapped them from Dubsado. Now we can also choose to set other things like who the assignee is, what status would we like it to have, and so on. And then we can click continue. Now it wants us to do another test. The first test was testing if it could pull data from Dubsado. The second test is saying, can it send information to ClickUp? Because remember, Zapier is our translator. This is testing the second part of the relationship. We're gonna go ahead and click test and continue. We wait, and we can see the task was successful, which means that now when we go into ClickUp, we will see that task for Dubsado. Now, to actually finish this whole process, we need to make sure this Zap is turned on. So we can click this button here or just hit the toggle in the top right corner. So with that, we're pretty much good to go. Every time a project is created as a job in Dubsado, we create a task inside ClickUp. Now, just one final note about using Zapier. Yes, what I just showed you can be done on the free plan, but if you find yourself having very high frequency triggers, meaning you have a lot of projects being created, or you just find yourself using a lot of them in the sum of a month, you might want to upgrade to a paid plan of Zapier because you get what you pay for, right? So on the free plan of Zapier, which is all you need to do what I just showed you, you are limited to 5 zaps, meaning 5 unique situations, and you only get 100 of them per month, meaning you could only have 100 support tickets with the example I just did in each month before it just stopped working and you'd receive a notification. Also, there's a 15-minute update time. What this means is Zapier isn't always looking at your Dubsado to see if something new happened. It's only looking every 15 minutes, which for most of us is going to be fine. But again, if you have high volume, high frequency, high speed transactions and you really need them to get into ClickUp right away, you might find it valuable to upgrade to a higher paid plan so you get more zaps, faster zaps, and so on and so forth. But in conclusion, this is how we can connect Dubsado and ClickUp for the onboarding process of a task, or really any stage in the process, using Zapier. We're allowing two tools to do what they do best and using Zapier to help them talk to each other so we're not retyping information. This was a pretty detailed tutorial, so if you have questions about this, don't hesitate to post in the comments below. So if you need to reference this later, be sure to save this video to your playlist. Also, give it a thumbs up, comment, all those kinds of things just to make sure that this shows up in your YouTube algorithm and helps this video reach more people beyond just you. All right, so to wrap up, as dogs are barking and people seem to be playing Ultimate Frisbee like right outside my window, I just wanna wrap us up with a quick poll to ask you what kind of content you would like to see next year on the channel. This is our automation month. We're focused on a lot of automation scenarios, but I would love to hear what kind of tools you would like to connect to ClickUp to give you some more actionable and relevant examples. So in one breath, I was thinking maybe some more Dubsado stuff in terms of how you can connect Dubsado and ClickUp in different ways. The other thought I had was connecting ClickUp with G Suite and different Google products, because I know a lot of you are also using that. I would just love to hear in the comments below. Leave the word Dubsado in the comment below if you would like to see more videos about Dubsado and ClickUp. And on the flip side, leave the word Google below if you'd like to see more videos about Google and ClickUp, or G Suite and ClickUp stuff. So I really appreciate your feedback on that. I think that'll just help us get a little bit of better direction. Someone just won the game and there's lots of noise outside, so I think that is my time to just end this video before I continue stuttering and trying to stop. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys back here for another video just like this. And if you can hear me over that noise, I hope you can. But otherwise, I think that's it for this pretty in-depth tutorial. If you'd like to see more about automations in ClickUp, definitely watch this playlist. It's got all the good stuff, all the content we're doing both now and in the future about automations inside ClickUp. Until next time, enjoy the process.